Thank you very much, Chairwoman. We both very much appreciate the opportunity to come up and discuss and testify before Congress on this critical issue, and we share many of the concerns that have already been raised in terms of the importance of our relationship with Taiwan. Let me also thank my colleague and friend, Congressman Berman, for his leadership on Asia, my friend, Congressman Fali Mavenga, for all his work in the Pacific, and Congressman Smith for his extraordinary work on issues associated with separated families and left-behind parents in Japan. If you could also communicate to Mr. Manzulu, after the tragic earthquake in New Zealand, we've worked with him and his staff. The United States is now the leading supporter of the rebuilding of the lovely town of Christchurch in New Zealand. We appreciate his leadership. I ask and thank the chairwoman to have my testimony, my full testimony, put on the record, and I will just quickly go over a few points if I could. I want to just paint a general strategic picture of what I think our nation is involved in right now. A major pivot, a major rebalancing in terms of our foreign policy and national security priorities. We are in the process of responsibly moving from important, consequential activities in the Middle East and South Asia to more focus on the Asia-Pacific region. And it's absolutely clear that we as a nation, the executive branch, the Congress, we need to step up our game in the Asia-Pacific region across the board. Trade, investment, security issues, institutions, and political and strategic engagement across the board. Our allies, new friends and partners like India, Indonesia, building a strong partnership with China, all of the countries in the Asia-Pacific region look to the United States as the key player in terms of the provision of our security guarantees and the maintenance of peace and stability, not only across the Taiwan Strait, but across Asia as a whole. We are in the midst of this. This will take many years. It will be difficult. We have enduring, extraordinarily expensive, difficult challenges in the Middle East, but Asia beckons. Much of the history of the 21st century will be written in Asia. The United States has to play a significant role in that. A critical part of that overarching strategy is building a comprehensive, durable, and unofficial relationship between the United States and Taiwan. It's essential. The bedrock of that relationship is our security relationship, and that is founded on several principles and key understandings. The Taiwan Relations Act stipulates, it's one of the most important acts of legislative leadership and foreign policy in our history. It stipulates that the United States must maintain the capabilities to resist coercion, to maintain peace and stability. We provide necessary defense articles to Taiwan, and it also requires us to consult actively on Capitol Hill on all issues associated with Taiwan. Taiwan Relations Act plus the so-called six assurances and the three communiques form the foundation of our overall approach. But our relationship is not simply a defense relationship. It is much broader. We seek to expand our economic and our trade relations. The trade relationship today between the United States and Taiwan is larger than the relationship between the United States and India. That's how significant it is. And we actually share the goals of moving forward on the TIFA agreement. One of the most important things that we hear from congressional friends is how critical issues like beef are in terms of how they are treated. And I must say, in our discussions with Taiwan friends, we have been disappointed with their lack of progress on this matter, but we are committed to make progress on this and building a deeper relationship with Taiwan economically and commercially going forward. Chairwoman, I also agree with you that on the people-to-people level, it's important to take critical steps. The visa waiver program is extraordinarily significant. We've made much progress in recent months, and we are aiming towards the very goal that you are aspiring to as well. So we see a broad-range, unofficial relationship as deeply in the interests of the United States going forward. Some have suggested that there is an inconsistency with building a strong, comprehensive partnership with China and maintaining a strong relationship with Taiwan. I think that's false. And I think if you look over the last several administrations, there have been an attempt to build a strong partnership with China and at the same time maintain a critical key relationship with Taiwan. And I think that's exactly what we have done in the Obama administration. And I think in terms of the consequences, the positive outcome of this, you see also a strong improvement in relations across the Taiwan Strait between China and Taiwan in recent years. That's very much in U.S. interests. Now, we have also stated very clearly that we, too, are concerned by military buildup across the Taiwan Strait. We have communicated that directly, not just to China, but all of our allies and friends in the regions who share these concerns. We think that these steps are antithetical to China's own interest in building a better relationship with Taiwan. Ultimately, it is in American interest to see democracy flourish in Taiwan. One of the things that binds us most closely is this democratic experience. In January, Taiwan will be conducting a major election both at the executive and the legislative levels. The United States supports that election. We don't play favorites. We don't choose candidates. We will work closely with any leader or leadership that emerges there. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you very much, Dr. Campbell.